Good morning, Antique and Garden Showcase friends. As you can tell, it's a very bright, sunny day here. This is day two of having super weather for the end of February. I mean, I got in the car yesterday afternoon and the temperature gauge said 81 degrees. Now it was probably 75, 76, but still for February, wow, that's really crazy for here in Kentucky 6B. So we're going to enjoy it while we have the chance. I actually got out and seeded the yard. So I did get the overseeding done. I didn't video any of that. It was just simply putting a mixture of cool weather fescue seed on the yard to kind of boost that and get it going. Today, my focus is going to be all the stuff in the back of this car are all the flower pots. So in between merchandising at one of my stores today, I'm going to try to take a break, get to the mini mall, get this set up, get back and get a huge project finished. So on the road a lot. And then if I have time, I'm going to go to a auction preview this afternoon. So lots of road time, lots of things to do. Got to get in here and get started. Okay, well, it's actually a start, but it's I only had four crates. I probably got six crates of these things to bring up, but I only had four today. So I'm putting these in. I put the mid-century styled sets here and then use the table for the larger pots and things. We still have the display cart there. We've got the little tricycle left. And I've got this little dog planter left, which I'm keeping close by. But other than that, I've got to work on getting the rest of them up here tomorrow. So that's all I've got for right now. If these sell well, I'm probably gonna have to get more because I really got space to fill in too, and maybe bring some different designs. But I wanna see how well these take off first. So the next mission today is to check out this auction preview that's here locally. I just want to see if there's anything that maybe I could find for the booth. There's a couple of things I might be interested in here. I just thought I'd go in and take a look around. I'll probably do voiceover on this part if I take any video in here. Well, with this auction company, I tend to go right. They have furniture to the right and smalls to the left. So I'm checking out the furniture here. I tend to check out all the items in an auction, even if I'm not completely interested in them. This little piece was in good condition. I just thought, well, I'll check it out, see what it's made out of, and I always kind of look in the drawers, look at the construction to see. Now, this is probably a more modern piece. You can tell there's no dovetail construction on the doors. More of a decorator type piece, and it does have a marble, green marble top on it, which kind of dates that probably more to the 90s, I would say, just as a guess, as green marble had its popularity around that time. There's an older etagere and a really pretty buffet there as well. Like I said, I tend to check out everything whether I'm interested or not. Now down this aisle, this shelf was listed. I thought it was nice, but it did list as having damage. There was a finished damage to the top there. You can see kind of a crinkle. And on down, that I checked out this vase. I couldn't tell if it was porcelain or what. It was almost like a resin material or something, but it still had a pretty finish to it. But this auction was a whole lot more decorator items, but there were some classic pieces as well, like this Kentucky Cherry two-drawer table that's here that was in really good condition. And those two plaid chairs were in good condition. This is a Pennsylvania House piece. I was kind of looking at it. Chest of drawers and things sell well just by themselves in the location that I'm at. And I like the dental molding. It was made out of solid oak. It was a good piece with dovetail construction. And there was a matching nightstand there as well. It did go with a bedroom suit, and I think that ended up selling more together. So I wasn't able to actually get those pieces. I'll do a separate video showing you what I actually did get from this auction. Looked at this little plant stand. It was iron. It was really a neat little piece. And this cart was really nice. Kind of brass mid-century. Looks more like a hotel type cart there. There were some glass top tables. Lots of mirrors. There was another one of these little console tables, but this one had a small damaged area on the front there at the bottom right. There's a missing piece of veneer. And I thought, well, if that piece does not go that high because of that, I can always fix a piece of veneer pretty quickly. And it had some metal ornaments on that.
This one had a black marble top, still the same type of construction as the other one. Always kind of feel around the top to see if there's any chips or anything on the outside edges, because that can ruin the value. Now, this table was one that I looked at online, but I thought, well, I'm going to look at it in person to see if I like it. I would not choose this table because of the finish issues that needed to be worked out. There were a lot of things on it. It would take a lot of time to get that back up to the condition I would like for it to be in if I was to put that in my booth for resale. On this wall, there were some really pretty modern pieces of art that had a classic look. These are oil paintings, and these are typically artists done in a factory. And that beauty right there, I will spoil for you, came home with me, and it's probably going to go somewhere in the house. The pretty floral still life. Yeah, that one was a keeper, I hope. If I can get a crane and get it lifted up the wall where I want it to be, it is heavy. So over to the smalls. They have shelves and shelves and shelves of smalls, and I tend to look through these like I do the furniture. I look through everything. Now, this lot I had not looked up online, but it was some pretty crystal pieces that caught my eye, some really neat decanters. I did not end up getting those, but they were really nice pieces. Kind of an unusual design there. I was checking it to make sure there were no cracks or flaws or things like that, because that can ruin the value of a resale really, really quickly. And I've had it happen before. You know, auctioneers and auction houses miss things just like we all do. This is a set of different stands. I was looking at those for display stands. Lots of just random decorator stuff here. There were some more pictures there, more pictures on the shelves. There were some more crystal candlesticks. They're really heavy. Those were super quality. I mean, they had the weight to them. So I kind of pointed to that number. I thought, well, Mark, watch 100D and see if that's one that might do well. On the other side, there were some hurricanes. There was also a big jardiniere with a stand there that was still a more modern jardiniere. If you saw the one that I bought before, it's not near as old as the one I bought. Two little kind of buffet lamps there. I considered those. There's a more modern ginger jar. There was not a lot of antiques in this one, but there were good quality home good reproduction type things in here. There were some mixed in, but it was a very eclectic collection of different things. But all of these pieces are really high-end, high-quality type pieces as well. Looking on around, there were a couple of things here that I had not seen. That was a met, I believe that was a met latch. Can't tell what that said on there. But anyway, there was another little piece there that had kind of a bronze, looked like a little bronze ormolu type stand it was in. Never could tell what that mark was either, but some of you may know. This piece had one piece of mulberry. The little jar back there was a mulberry flow blue. This little rabbit picture was a modern reproduction. So was the plate below it. So there was a mixture in that box. I had considered that lot, but then I decided against it after I saw it. This piece was very, very pretty, very colorful. Nice piece of art glass there. I believe that to be Murano, the way it's finished on the back. This piece I checked out because I honestly thought it might have been some of my grandmother's porcelain that she painted, but after inspection, I could tell it wasn't her work, didn't have her signature, and I used to order a lot of her blanks for her, and I kind of knew that this was not a blank that I had ever ordered for her to paint on. So always check out though, because in the local area, I never know if I'm going to run up on a piece that she sold at a church bazaar or at a show or something that somebody picked up. There was a blue Fenton vase in the end there, some rabbits, some little figurines of different types. I picked these up. They were unusual little dogs, but they were reproduction made in China on there. Like I said, Mark Roberts in there, but those were really cute. If somebody was decorating with that style, there were animals of all kinds. There were camels and dogs and even giraffes. That guy was kind of interesting, and I almost considered bidding on that piece just for the interest factor.
Well, there were lots of nice things to see at the auction and a lot of things that I'm really going to look at tonight. Hopefully, we'll be seeing some new things come in really soon. And here on the side of the house, when I got in, I had quite a surprise today. My mom had been outside working. She was enjoying the outside weather, and she got all of this cleaned up. Look at this. There are no more magnolia leaves on the ground. It's all completely cleaned up around here. And of course, I did the big stick pile. I've got to get my mess cleaned up down there. But wow, what a surprise. And all this, these little old cones that come off of here are really a trip hazard out in the yard. And I think she was wanting those up and just, she was ready to get outside and get some sunshine too. It's 80 degrees here today. I'm in short sleeve shirt and shorts on February the 23rd, just so we have this day in history marked. So thank you all for watching Antique and Garden Showcase. I hope you have a great weekend, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.